Good morning, guys. I'm back. I've had so many of you so sweetly ask me to do vlogs. I've been at a loss of what to do here on my channel. I've really missed vlogging, and so many of you have really missed seeing my vlogs. Thank you so much for that. I've just been in a funk. I really have. And I didn't know what path I wanted to take here on my channel. I really didn't. But as I was sitting here watching TV this morning, I just realized if I'm going to start vlogging, I need to just pick up the camera and start doing it, right? Like every day I think, okay, maybe tomorrow I'll start. No, I need to just pick up the camera and start. And back in the beginning of January, I edited and uploaded a vlog video. It wasn't even the footage that I edited and uploaded. Like once it went live, it was like me putting on makeup, like clips from another video. And I thought, I don't even know what happened. I really don't. But there were some clips in that vlog that I would still like to show you guys. My granny's white chicken chili recipe. I'll probably go ahead and stick those in this video. We are heading to the bank and to McDonald's. Get a little bit of breakfast. It's almost noon though. Right, David?
Yep. Been awake since 5.
David got in at 4 this morning. And he was just, what was you just giving me a hard time about? Well, I don't work.
No, you don't.
I work like a Trojan. Cleaning
that's,
our house up
right.
And the apartment. Catching up on a little bit of Bachelor. While we watch, oh, can y'all see? I have to cut these nails off. Look how long. I like long nails, but now this is just a little bit crazy. So I'm gonna trim my nails off. Hey guys, so it is about 7:30. I'm ready for dinner. Waiting on David per usual. Let's do a little bit of OOTD. We're in this probably 7 or 8 year old sweater from J. Crew. It is sequined on the front. I like sequins, honey. And then just American Eagle jeans and my black knee boots. My chatty get ready with me video actually just went live maybe about an hour ago. You guys are so sweet. You always, always lift my spirits. You have no idea. And I appreciate you so much. So, getting back into the swing of things. Getting my spirits up, you know. trying to be positive. So, we'll probably leave here within the hour. And we're going to try a Vietnamese restaurant tonight. So, on the TV right now while I wait. Classic. How many of y'all like 16 Candles? Jake Ryan was life.
Is that a gem?
Looks like it is. We are here, guys. We're going to try this out. This Vietnamese cuisine. How do you say it? Pho BC? Phu BC? I don't know. We're going to give it a whirl. Good morning, guys. So it's Saturday morning. I didn't check back in last night because it was horrible. So we go to this restaurant, and I did find out it's pho. I thought it was pho, it's pho. And I had the beef pho. But you know, I was sick last week with that stomach virus or whatever it was. And I don't think my stomach was ready to handle spicy food like that. Because I did lay the sriracha to it. Guys, to say I was sick last night was an understatement. So, after that, I really wasn't in the mood to film. I felt kind of rough. So, went on to bed after that, and we've been up for a while this morning watching some TV, watched the 2020 special, Anna Nicole, I think it was 2020, Anna Nicole's death. It's the 10-year anniversary of that. I can't believe it's been that long, but getting ready to watch a movie, a Hallmark movie I've got on the DVR, and going to drink another cup of coffee. Probably going to run out today and go to Sam's Club and get a few things that we need. And I don't know. Probably going to take it easy today, guys, just to be honest. And then tomorrow we'll have church and that kind of thing. And I'm going to be cooking. So, yeah, that's probably what we're looking at for the rest of the weekend. A few of you have asked me how I'm doing with my marshmallow hot chocolate creamer. I'm down to my last bottle. So, trying to ration it. This movie that we're getting ready to watch is called Love Locks. It's a Hallmark movie. And my dental assistant at the dentist office a couple weeks ago told me that she always thinks of me whenever she sees this movie. Let me fast forward to it. Oh. But this is a Rebecca Romijn and Jerry O'Connell movie. Look, it's Paris. David, will you take me back to Paris? I want to go back. Good morning, guys. It's Sunday morning. I bathed the dogs last night. Darcy got her hair cut off. So we are on our way to church. Got this little style inspo from Jaclyn Hill on Snapchat yesterday. She went out with her friends, I think, to go see 50 Shades Darker. And she had on the cutest little outfit, and it was like a leopard print scarf with a destroyed kind of blue jean jacket. And she paired hers with like a white t-shirt and some black leggings and some tennis shoes. But where we are going to church, honey, I did dress it up a little. Paired mine with my I paired mine with my destroyed express jeans and a pair of ankle boots. So I'll go ahead and show you that to give you a little bit of idea on how we be looking. So jeans and my boots, and then a hateful rump over here always rushes me whenever I'm trying to get ready for church, so I didn't have that much time to work like on my makeup or whatever. So
rush, we're about 20 minutes late for church.
Anywho, did a super sexy like smoky eye. I flat love a really just dark lid, and then you blend it out in the crease. It's kind of a graduated smoky eye. It's one of the easiest smoky eyes to do and one of the fastest. So I just used the dramatic black Maybelline color tattoo on my lid, and I blended it out in the crease with my Too Faced peanut butter and jelly palette and put on loads of mascara and black eyeliner, and we're done. So got a plain little nude lip here. This is the Marc Jacobs, what is that lip gloss called? Whatever his lip glosses are called in Sugar Sugar. So how far are we from church? 5 minutes?
Yes.
Yeah, so perfect timing. So it just occurred to me that I should be vlogging. I just got through frying us some burgers, some pepper jack cheese, and now I am going to toast me a pretzel bun. Guys, do you all do pretzel buns? They're so good. I like to put some butter, a cast iron skillet, okay, and then just take your bun and kind of soak up some of that butter, all the butter, and you let it get toasted, okay? All right. So then I'm going to top it with a ton of lettuce. I love a lot of lettuce on my burger. And probably put some pickle on mine as well. And that'll be it. Hey guys. So I'm getting ready for bed. It is a little after 9. But yeah, honey, I'm going to call it a day. I hope that you enjoyed this weekend vlog. I didn't do much this weekend. It was a really low-key weekend. So I'm going to go to bed, guys. I love you. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Good night. Alrighty. So I'm going to let you all take your place right atop the bow tie jar. Been a while, huh? And I'm going to get this chicken boiling. I've mentioned it before. Anytime you use chicken, say in a soup or a stew, boil it, and you get it flakes better. You know, it kind of gets stringy better. These thighs are actually partially frozen. All right. I'm just going to salt my water pretty generously with some kosher salt. I'm also going to put some black pepper down in there while they cook. So those are going. I'm going to go ahead and take you over here and show you the actual recipe, okay? It's my little granny's recipe. Here, let me turn my book up. This is granny's white chicken chili. So what it calls for are 4 cans of white meat only chicken, and you drain it, okay? 3 cans of Great Northern white beans, 1 32-ounce chicken broth, a 16-ounce jar of salsa, 8 ounces of pepper jack cheese, and 2 teaspoons of cumin. Cook all of that in the crock pot for 3 hours on high and then 1 hour on low. And where nothing's really raw in here, you know, the beans are cooked, the meat is already cooked, and it's basically just to melt everything together and get it nice and hot and bubbly, okay? So my aunt cooks this on the stovetop all the time, but where the chicken that I'm using is raw, I am going to boil it until it's done. And then I'll add it into the crock pot with all the other stuff, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and get everything dumped into the crock pot. Alrighty. Everything laid out here. That way I can show it all to you as I put it in. You basically just dump it all into your crock pot, okay? This is a super simple recipe. And she got it from some people down south. I think maybe in Alabama. I don't remember where she said. Use any kind of salsa that you like. I'm using, I got mild. I meant to get medium. Because David really does like spicy food. Not too spicy, but a little spicy. And I get mine that's already shredded. It's just 8 ounces. Everything started cooking. Okay, and then I'm going to get my beans opened up and pour them in as well. And there's barely any juice in Great Northern beans, so I just pour it in. It doesn't say to drain it, and I never have. And it's so delicious and easy. And mine are just Bush's Best Great Northern beans. Use any kind. All right. And then the only other thing this has got left is the cumin. It calls for 2 teaspoons. This is the only thing I really vary on. We're big cumin people, honey. Do close to a tablespoon. Because we really do just love it. And that's it. Let me pick you up here and let you look in the pot. Again, if you are following the recipe, you're going to have your cans of chicken in here as well. But this cooks up so good, and it's just great on a cold winter day. We're supposed to get snow tomorrow, so this should be perfect. But got it set for high, and it's on 4 hours. But in 3 hours, I'll turn it down to low. All right, so all there is to it. I have got my chicken a bowling. So as soon as this gets done, I will go ahead and shred it with a couple of forks and add it to my crock pot. Alrighty guys, so I have all of my chicken pulled apart and shredded. Okay, I'm gonna toss it here in the chili. And I just guessed at the amount of chicken to put in this. I normally use the cans, and I think it turns out really good when you use the cans. But Choir Tail likes fresh chicken, so that's what he gets. All right. Smells delicious. But once all your cheese melts and all that jazz, so good. Okay. So this has been cooking. This has still got a couple more hours. I didn't shred that piece too well. This has still got at least a couple more hours on high, and then we'll go an hour on low. So I'm going to close the lid and let it get to cooking again. All right, guys, so the white chicken chili is complete. I did salt and pepper mine just a little bit, but David likes his food pretty daggone salty. most of you probably wouldn't have to do it, especially if you're using canned chicken. But, yeah, looks so good, and he's going to love this. So, great recipe. I love one-dish meals. So simple. Toss everything in your crock pot, and you're done. So, hope y'all enjoy it.